are what I consider family history, family search experts. They work at the Family Search Center at the Mesa Temple Visitor Center. They're also our columnist in the Arizona Beehive magazine for our family history section. So I've asked them to come here tonight and give you a presentation on using technology for family history, and I know they'll have some extra good stuff for you as well. So Glenn, come on up, and thank you very much.
So I'm going to be talking a lot about family search. And family search was put together, the actual historical records, since about for about 30 years. But family search, family tree, has only been around for 11 years. And it's a marvelous tool that continues to evolve and expand. Now, how many of you have logged on to family search before? Okay. So most of you have probably not gone any place besides signing in here. So I'm going to scroll down here a little bit. Start discovering your family story, U.S. Census, find your family in the world's largest shared family tree. So family search is a shared family tree. So we're all in it together. I can see your families, at least the deceased ones. Yeah. We're going to demonstrate that here in a minute. So it's a shared tree. We all work on it together. Ancestry.com, you have individual trees out there. Yeah. And that's a good place to do research and record potential stuff. But Family Search is a shared tree. And how much does it cost?
Nothing.
It's free. Why is it free? People say, why on earth are we doing this for free?
Because we pay tithes.
Family Search is an international nonprofit organization dedicated to helping all people discover their family story. Right? Mm-hmm. Past, present, and future. Most of the people who have an account on Family Search are not members of the church.
Wow. Really?
Way more people have a free account and are adding to the tree that are not members of the church.
We worked in Salt Lake for a year and a half, and I would say 80% of the people we worked with were not members of the church.
Wow.
Okay.
Okay.
So.
That's something.
So I'm not logged on to Family Search.
No.
So. I assume your father is deceased.
Yes.
How about giving me his name?
J-E-A-N.
J-E-A-N.
Hulme, H-U-L-M-E. Linford is the last name.
H-U-L-M-E.
Hulme. Linford.
L-I-N-F-O-R-D.
I tell you. See, I got it. All right. Where did he live?
He grew up in Cache Valley, Logan, Utah.
Oh. That's where I'm from.
Oh. Okay.
That's where my grandma lived.
My dad lives.
No. Let's
see.
Kyle. We're trying to find him.
What about his birth year?
He was born in 1911. I think it was January 24th, 1911. Let's see.
Okay.
Wow. So my computer tells me all the time.
Yeah, right. So anyway.
Is it logged on? Or did when it went off, did that go out too?
No, it's,
the internet must have worked.
Oh boy.
Pictures are on there, right?
Sometimes the internet inside the church.
That's one of the problems in this room. We are a long ways from where things are, and sometimes it loses connections.
I was logged here on here a minute ago.
Bummer.
All right.
Wow. This is recorded in Turkey.
Okay. So, how many of you have used Family Search on your phone? Have the app Family Tree app on your phone?
Yep.
Okay.
That's why I'm asking a lot of you, because I don't
Let's go ahead and bring up that app, if you've got it.
But I can't get on.
Right there, okay? So you can actually see the, you can have a fan chart show on your tree app as well. Okay. All right, so it looks like we're back in business. So we're going to be looking at, so whatever you do on your tree app, it works on what, if you're looking at it from your computer at home. So the question is, what's the computer of the future? How many people in the world have a laptop or have a phone? Do more people have phones or laptops?
Phones
by far. So this is the platform that your church really does. There's things that you can do with your phone that you can't do with a laptop computer. All right. So let's try this again. All right. So we're going to look for that name again. What was it?
J-E-A-N. Hume is his middle name, H-U-L-M-E.
And he lived in Utah.
Yeah, Logan, Utah.
Okay, here we go. Let's see if we can find it.
There it is.
Hume Linford. Now look, I'm not logged on, am I? Did I sign in?
That's
no.
His mom
no.
Right here.
Oh
my God. No, and that's your grandfather,
James
Linford, right?
Yep.
So there he is right there. So, there's a brief life history of Gene Hume. This is AI, artificial intelligence, created this little story here from the records and things that are out there on Family Search.
A lot.
There's a lot.
57 memories.
Yeah, a whole bunch of memories, 57 memories, parents and siblings. You've got a brother who passed away.
Yes, my
right?
older brother Lauren.
Your older away. Brother Lauren passed away. Yeah.
Right.
So this is kind of fun. You can actually see things without logging on. Now, I'm going to go ahead and sign in here. Okay, so there he is. Well, let's look at we're going to be looking at your tree.
Okay.
This is Lauren.
That's Lauren, my older brother.
Your older brother.
He passed away. So that's him when he was a baby with my mother.
Huh.
That's
cool.
Yeah.
Good curly hair. He got in a really bad accident on the freeway there,
yeah.
I-15.
Yeah.
Off to I-15. He was at a wedding reception and they came back and it was ice and a semi. Was it a semi?
Oh, no.
He died that night right in the car on his wife's lap.
Yeah.
Okay. So Lauren's tree is going to look like your tree as far as ancestors are concerned.
Yes.
Right?
Let's see, that's yours.
So, am I logged on? Brother Linford's account?
No.
No.
I can't see him because he's alive, but I can see his brother.
Yeah.
And there's your parents. So there's the fan chart is really a neat option because you can see this is the birthplace view. You've got United States, United Kingdom, England, British Colonial America. So you've got all U.S. and I can do one more generation. I'll add a generation.
Is that yours?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, because it's my brother.
You
got to
see mine.
It's the same as mine.
Yeah, so it's the same thing because it's your older brother's tree. And it's the same.
How did you add the generations?
Right up here. If you look here, here's the different ways. Right on this thing is you can add generations. So the family, okay, you can add generations, I can look at six generations, let's just look, I'll just look at five generations here. Okay, so it's a little bit bigger and you can read it. So here with the fan chart, there's different options you can do. Say, I want to see who has photos out there. Do you think some of your families put photos out there?
For sure.
Let's look at photos. Wow, this says 10 plus photos. Everybody going back one, two, three, four generations has 10 or more photos out there. So there's a lot of stuff out there. Okay? So, let's see who has stories. There's some stories out there. So, what's fun about this, now, this ordinance is see if anybody on your four generations need ordinances. Whoops, somehow we got the wrong guy. Here we are, we're back. Got you back. Something's off with Charlene as far as ordinances. Maybe they gave her the wrong husband or something.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so the other thing we can do is sources. Sources are census records, birth records, death records, all kinds of other things documenting accuracy about your family. How many sources are there for your five generations?
Yeah.
More than 10 on every single one of them.
Wow.
Every single one of them, right?
Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah, so it's kind of interesting. All right, now we're going to look at your tree.
Mm-hmm.
We'll look at your tree, okay?
Okay.
Let's find out. What. So on Family Search, what you have is you've got the tree, see up here on the left? You see up on the left up there, on your left, you see family, tree, search, memories, get involved, activities, and temple. Okay? So family tree is where you put in the relationships. Search is where you search for historical records. Birth, marriage, death, census records, all kinds of other records. And then memories, where you can put in memories. Photos, stories, and documents. How many have put a memory out on Family Search Family Tree? Okay. So I tell people, what are your kids going to do with all of your photo albums? What are they going to do?
Throw them away.
They're going to throw them out, aren't they? So you want to pick the best ones, the things that are meaningful, and you can put them out there on Family Search.
I just inherited 32 photo albums from my parents.
32? Oh.
Wow.
Wow.
So let's look here.
That's excellent.
Excellent.
We're going to look at the
look at it.
Profile for your father here. Okay, now when you look at the personal page profile, this is out there, there's a tree. And each individual has a profile. You know how many profiles we have out there on Family Search? Anybody want to guess?
Millions.
Millions?
A billion.
1.2 billion.
Wow.
That's that many profiles. Now there's a few duplicates out there because I find duplicates all the time. But
400 million duplicates.
Probably. So there's probably a billion people out there.
Well, I've got like 15 of me, because each of my kids and my grandkids.
Yeah.
And
oh, right.
Yeah, okay, so if you look down here at Jean Hume Linford, the first part is vital information. What do we see there?
Birth.
Name, birth date, death, burial, sex.
Marriage.
Okay. Marriage. Now, the marriage isn't there. This is the marriage. Is he a marriage up here?
No.
No, this is just about him. So if we go down, there's other information. Now there's custom events. Now here's the family information. Okay, there is your mother and father, your grandparents, and all your parents, your father's siblings. Okay, there they all are, all together. Now if you wanted to print this out so you could refer to it, it used to be really hard to do. Let me show you how easy it is now. You go to print options, print person details. And I don't want to see all this other information, but I want to see the vitals and the family. There it is. I can just print that.
Wow, that's
great. So that's really cool. That's something that was recently put there. Because I was always doing a screen capture and trying to print it. It was all messed up. So this is really nice, what they did.
Yeah, print option.
Print option. So for any person you have there, what are some other print options you can do? Let's look. You can print a pedigree. We all know what pedigree. Who used to fill out those four generation pedigree charts, right?
Oh yeah.
How many still have a pile of them?
Have the long.
Yeah, the binder. Long ones, right?
Long
yeah.
Binder.
People come in and say, "What do we need those for?" Well, you can see if you find something, it might have some neat stories on. It's probably worth saving. But I shall have some. But you don't need them anymore.
For people that we have worked with to look through them. So far, we have not found people that are missing. They're already all on family.
Well, I found Bruce Goldthorpe. He had some pedigree charts that were not there. We got them there.
Huh. Wow.
So there are some. So you can do a pedigree. So if you go ahead and do a pedigree, we're going to print a pedigree chart. There's the pedigree chart.
Wow. Yeah.
Four generations.
That's different.
So it shows the... those X's are all about the ordinances that are done. Ordinances that are done. Okay? Now, if you want to do a portrait pedigree, well, there's a portrait pedigree. There's a lot of pictures out there. Right?
Yeah.
Charles Rich.
Charles C. Rich.
Charles C. Rich.
All right. Now, you can also do a family group record. That lists all the detailed information about the family, husband and wife, and all the kids.
That's kind of like the old-fashioned.
Yeah, yeah, it's the old-fashioned one.
Except you get new information also.
So now, let's do, so if I went here, if I go here to James Wesley Linford, your grandfather,
yeah.
And if I do a group sheet there, if I do print options, and I do a family group record, it's going to have lots more information. There's actually 2 pages of information.
Wow.
Of all the kids and their information, right?
Because they have to be deceased.
Have to be deceased. Now, if you have them on your tree, you can put living people on your tree.
Right.
Like you're on your tree.
Right.
Yeah.
But deceased people.
And you can print it out.
Yeah.
Okay. Like you as a living
as
person
a living
on
person,
there.
Yeah. So deceased people are shared, living people are not shared.
Not shared, right.
Yeah. Okay.
But so like now, your kids, they would have to enter you as a living person.
Okay.
Now this is one thing that's interesting. You noticed how he talked about, or how he found people by an ID number?
Yeah.
We each have an individual ID number.
But
his ID number for me is different than my ID number.
But you,
because I'm a living person.
You've got at least 2 ID numbers because your wife probably has you on her tree, and you have her on her tree, and you have different numbers. You got your own.
So if you try and say, "I'm going to add them by using this ID number," and you try it, they'll say that number does not exist.
Yeah, living things aren't shared. Living ID numbers are so.
Okay.
Now let's do a fan chart. Now, if you try to print a fan chart from here, this is the type of fan chart that you get.
James Wesley,
that's
your grandfather.
So it's just, so if we get, now, if you're at the Mesa second floor, it'll print an 11 by 17.
Oh, big ones.
Big ones. But this creates a PDF document, and if you know what a PDF document is, it'll print. So if you try to screen capture stuff and try to print it, it just goes all wacko. So you can if you're on the page where you've got a fan chart, and if I wanted to do photos, and if I did the print, that's what it would look like. But that's not as exciting.
Yeah.
The only thing I would want to print, if I were doing that, is the birthplace.
Okay.
Because that's...
It's recorded.
Yeah. Because that's kind of interesting to look at.
Yeah.
Right?
That's cool.
So, okay. All right, so we're going to try to find your father.
Sure.
Charles Leonard.
Charles.
You've got to go back to find by name.
Oh yeah, find by name.
Teamwork.
Thank you, Lynn. Leonard? Last name?
Heaton. H-E-A-T-O-N.
T-O-N. Okay. Where did he live?
Arterville, Utah.
Utah. Let's see if we can find him. Charles Leonard Heaton. Is that him?
That's him.
Parents, spouse, mother Edna, right? So let's go there. So the other thing that we didn't look at, let's see when his ordinances were done. He was baptized 15th of November, 1909. How old was he? He was eight. He got baptized when he was eight. Went to the temple 1926 when he was 25. Actually 24. Born in the covenant, sealed to his vows in 26. How about that? The same day he received his initiatory endowment, he was sealed to his wife.
Quite often that happens.
Yeah, it did, yeah.
We were.
Okay, so let's look for details. And my guess, you've got some deceased siblings.
Right.
Wow.
So.
Kezia? That's a name.
So there is. Look at that. A lot more color there. Canada, Scotland, Newfoundland, Ireland, England. Now what's British colonial America?
So the 13 colonies before the Revolutionary War?
That's exactly right. So if you were born before July 4th, 1776, you were born in British colonial America, if you were born in the area where the United States is. People don't always put that 100% accurate, but that's the difference. British colonial America is that timing. 1776, before or after.
That's okay. Just like there was a lady in our ward, and her birth certificate said Arizona Territory.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, so that was before 1912. You're born in Arizona Territory, if you're born in Arizona.
Wow.
Yeah, so, again, we're again demonstrating this is a shared tree and we're all working together. So, now, one thing that's interesting is there's another way. Let's pick an ancestor, say along this, let's pick this one right here. William Robertson. We're going to look at his tree. And we're going to change to looking at his descendants.
Now, does everybody know what he just did?
No.
I changed from a fan chart, I changed it to a descendancy chart. And what a descendancy chart does, looks at all the descendants. So if we went back and looked, which line do you come down? Any idea which one of these? You don't, do you? Because you don't know all those people that far back. So you could say, I want to go and look at four generations down. There's a lot of descendants. So what it amounts to, when I'm looking here, I've got you've got a lot of people on your tree who could be added. This particular person, William Stark, let's find out how you're related to William Stark. William Stark, if we want to look at relationships, how do we do that?
View relationship.
Oh, yeah. Okay? He is.
Oh my word.
The bottom.
Oh, this is me. This is no good. This is how I'm related. So, I'd have to be logged on to you. So, he's my third. So, we're cousins.
Yeah.
Crying out loud.
Yeah. Yeah, we're cousins. So I'm looking at descendancy here. So looking at this ancestor of yours, all of these children, Isabella Baxter and William Stark, they have 7 children. Do you think any of them got married?
Probably.
Do you think there would be a family living in the mid-1800s with 7 kids that never got married? None of those 7 kids? What's the likelihood that would happen?
Very low.
Very low. So
that doesn't show any of them got married.
Doesn't show any of them got married. So there's an opportunity to build the tree, to actually go and add a bunch of people to the tree. So you thought all your family history work was done, didn't you? That's what people say, it's all done. But anyway, this is just showing that there's other ways to add people. So anyway, kind of interesting. We'll go back to me here. Look at my fan, change it to fan chart. So, there's a fun activity that you can do. If there's lots of pictures out there, and you want to find out who you look the most like, you can do activities, compare a face. Okay? Compare a face. And you can then compare a face. Here's a previous image. There's me. I'm going to compare who I look like in my family.
No.
61%.
That's my mother.
Aww. Where's your dad?
My dad's right here. 60%.
Oh, yeah, you look like him.
Yeah, 60%. Then there's my great-grandfather.
Schwarzenegger.
And then great-grandfather. So I figured I really came from these people, right? Now, if I want to find out what celebrities I look like, the kids get crazy over this.
Oh, yeah.
They get so nice.
And over to the visitor center, every single computer that they have got has a little camera on it. So you'll see the kids that know what they're doing. They'll walk in and go like this and pull the camera up and take a picture and go.
I had a whole group of young men I was helping. And we printed out some family names for them to take to the temple. Then to the very end, I said, Let's do this compare face. Well, there's no camera here. So I pushed the top and this camera. Oh, well. So they were done. I'd never get it back. So that's why I did that the last time. So this says, I'm 41% compared to who?
Roger
Bannister. Ran the first
submit. Yeah, did you run as fast as he did?
I could not, no. And so, Pocahontas.
There, that guy.
Ronald Amundsen. Orville Wright. Yeah, so it's kind of fun. Yeah, okay. So, there's another activity that we were looking at, famous relatives. You can say church pioneers. Now, at a list 50, all these people are not my direct pioneer ancestors. A lot of them are cousins. This top row, they're all direct ancestors. This second row, the next 5, direct. The next 5, they're all direct. And Joseph Holbrook is direct. So I've got 16. But there's one they don't have here, and that's Judson Tolman's wife. For some reason, they missed her. But this guy right here, Benjamin Hewitt, if I look there, my relationship, he's my second great-granduncle. So he's not a direct pioneer ancestor. But Joseph Holbrook is my third great-grandfather. He's the ancestor I have who's the first member of the church. He was baptized in 1832.
Wow.
So, the story about him is he encountered the church and he started reading the Book of Mormon and he wouldn't stop. And his wife thought he'd gone nuts. He's out in the cornfield reading his Book of Mormon and she thinks he ought to be working. So she left and went to stay with her mother. Took their daughter, oldest daughter, which is my direct ancestor. But she ended up joining the church too. So there's a good story ended up on that. So it's fun to read about those things. So be interesting to see how many, because obviously you've got some pioneer ancestors or you wouldn't be, right?
Yeah.
Maybe you.
I don't.
Except you.
Right. You do.
Willie Hancock Company.
Willie Hancock, yeah.
I do too.
Me too.
Yep. Yep. We just did a Mormon Heritage tour from Council Bluffs all the way through Nebraska and Wyoming into Salt Lake.
Yeah.
7 days. It was really interesting to see all that stuff.
Yeah.
All right, so you can see which church leaders.
Brigham Young.
Brigham Young Jr. That's weird, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Kind of does. The Robert Hales, he is my third cousin once removed, pretty close. And he's connected to Joseph Holbrook with a different wife. Then you've got athletes. I only got, wow. I didn't see Babe Ruth. That's new. How am I related to Babe Ruth?
Yeah.
He's my 12th cousin once removed. Almost. I mean, right next to him. Right?
I had a conjointed twin brother. And my kids used to call him their uncle on my father's side.
It's not finished.
And then they separated us. Now they call him my uncle once removed.
Oh my
I'm related to Gordie Howe. See, Gordie Howe's my fifth cousin. That's pretty close, right? Fifth cousin. Yeah. So, anyway, then you've got.
Waiting for that, Craig.
Scientists.
Good timing.
Yeah.
Oh, we can fill him in.
Just about everybody who has a tree going back a ways is related to Abraham Lincoln, right? So it's kind of fun.
Or maybe I'll lose.
All you need to do is find somebody you can connect to.
I don't
yeah.
know.
Yeah. Anyway. Okay. So, now, one thing that's really important is, again, doing the memories. How many of you have added memories?
How many have done
it? Brother does a lot of it.
Okay, so lots of people have added memories. So now, when you add a memory, it goes in your gallery. So the gallery is where you put all the memories that you've added. Now this shows I've got 449 memories in my gallery, and I've got 490 memories in my archive. The reason I got lots of memories in my archive is because I'm crazy. I do obituaries. I go find people. Every week, I'll find three or four obituaries, and I connect them to their families and put them on Family Tree and connect them.
Wow. Oh, nice.
Yeah. So I've had some people thank me about that. So, and so what it amounts to is you can always find. When I look at an obituary, I just about can always connect them to somebody. In fact, sometimes somebody already put them on the tree and said they were dead. So I go in and say, they're really dead now. You thought they were dead, but they're really dead. So your gallery now, what it amounts to is, let's go. Now, let's go to the tree, family tree. So within the tree, each person. So if I go in here and look at my dad, he's got a lot of memories out there, and my wife put a lot of them out there. So here's the memories that my dad has. How many are there? 94. So there's a lot. So here's kind of an indictment, but yes.
Does a picture count as a memory?
Yeah, yeah. The type of memories you can have, photos, stories, documents, and audio recordings. You can do audio recordings, but not video recordings. So here is a picture of the Garden Park Ward High Priest and 70s, about 1961. And my dad is over here on the top row, second to top row, on your left. You can point him out. Now,
he looks just like you.
Right here.
So look in the very middle. See if you recognize somebody in the very middle.
Is that President Nelson?
Wow. Oh, yeah, there he is.
Oh.
That's Russell Nelson.
Oh, my God.
That's something?
After all.
These are the...
Tom.
And there is...
He is Tom.
Pierce.
You have to turn 99 the other day.
Yeah, so these are the... Yeah, so that's a really... And I went and I identified... I was able to identify almost everybody in the picture. Almost everybody in the picture, and I tagged them. So when you tag people, this picture goes on their profile.
Yeah.
So when you add photos, you want to tag people, and that's identifying
people.
How
do you do that?
Okay. What it amounts to, let's... So... So here's a photo, and what you do, it says click the image to tag people. So I've already tagged everybody, so you just click the person, and then you identify them. So to tag them, you just click the image, and then you can... So what I'm going to do, I'm going to delete this tag. So I'm going to go in here, I'm going to tag... So I click the image, there's my sister. Now you notice this little green thing on the lower corner.
Uh-huh.
That's what you can do. You got to play with that if you want to make it smaller. You got to hold it in the middle to move it over. So the only thing you can do is you got to play with that little green thing. It takes some practice. You can't do anything else but play with that green thing. Now if I want to identify who that is, it's Joanne Tolman. So her name came up because I've been to her before. So now, she's now tagged. Yeah.
They look alike.
They do, all right.
Now, if you type in their name and their name doesn't come up, then you can go into Family Search and find them and come bring that ID back and put it in, and then it will add it to them.
Yeah, you can attach it. So anyway, most of the kids know tagging because they do tagging on Facebook posts and things. So if you put a picture out there, you can... So that one picture that I was showing you, there's still some people I need to identify that I haven't identified in that picture that has President Nelson in it. So he was my stake president, and he was also in the bishopric when I was a teenager. Yeah, so. All right.
Swimming.
So here's, let's go back. So we'll do another tag. Let's see, where was that one that I had? I'll do this one thing here. Okay. Right here, I need to add a tag. Right here, I haven't put a title here. This is a duplicate. This right here is the Ryder Cup.
The Ryder Cup.
For golf.
Oh.
The real one.
The real one. It's the real one. So, I'm tagged in that one, so I need to add a title to it. So I was at the golf course, and this guy brought the Ryder Cup, and I got my picture taken with it. So I still need to put a title and document what this picture is.
When you are putting in memories, go back to that, Glenn. There's four things you always need to do. You need to tag them. You need to add a title. You need to add a place and a date.
Yeah.
Because if you don't add those things, okay, there's a picture. I could show you a picture of my dad. He added it and died after that. It's a picture of him as a pirate. That's all I have. No tag, no title, no date, no place. I was able to find out the information. But do you want people to know what's going on in the picture? You can also add a description down here if you want to. But absolutely add a title, a tag, a date, and a place.
Yeah.
And just get in the habit of every time you add a picture, do it. Oh, and it doesn't have to be a picture. It can be a death certificate or a birth certificate, or if their name is there, tag the name in the article or whatever, and then just add the other information.
Yeah. So this is the picture right at the end of my mission. I served in Tahiti in the South Pacific. Wow. And it says, President Ralph Richards in Maupiti. I tagged him, I've tagged myself, and identify. This picture is taken next to the Maupiti Chapel, left to right, or Chati Firu Mauru, Maupiti Branch President, Elder Richard Blake Smith, President Richards, Bora Bora Branch President, and me.
Are you the tall guy?
I'm on the right.
I'm on the right.
Oh. On your right, yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Shorter guy with the shells on his head.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Okay.
That is cool.
So of me, here's mine. I've got 48 memories, family pictures. There's my wife and I. There's me when I was a kid.
I don't see any photos of you working at Motorola.
No, I don't. I haven't done anything. I have a lot of documentation of that. Thought about throwing it all away, but it's a big part of my life. I probably had to do something.
My dad would go too.
Yeah. So anyway, so here's a elder ordination. Who signed it?
Russell M. Nelson.
Right, because he was the state president.
Sure.
Yeah, he's got beautiful handwriting.
To put a certificate like that in, do you scan it?
You can scan it. Yeah.
Or you can take a picture of it on your phone and upload it from your phone.
Yeah.
Scanning it is better quality.
Yeah, it's better quality.
Yes.
Yeah.
Can you do that at the family history?
Yeah, you can.
At the visitor center.
Visitor center there. Yes. Second floor.
If you find things other places and you don't have the ability to do that, take a picture of it.
Right.
You have a handheld scanner with you all the time.
Right.
Yeah, and so the other thing you can do is record something. If you have, record something about yourself. If you've got, of course, you probably still have a parent living, right? Record something about it. Your dad's, mom are still around. Record something of them.
I don't know whether you can get that one to play the recording for my mom.
I don't know. So, if I look at, we'll do that. So if I filter, and if I want to look for audio recordings, let's see if this plays. Nope, it's not playing. Anyway, if I disconnect it, this would be playing. We're not getting sound through it.
I wonder if it's not turned up on the TV.
Well, don't worry about it. So anyway, Lynn recorded something about her mother talking about when she threw snowballs the wrong direction when she was in elementary school, about 10 years old, and she got taken to the principal's office because she threw snowballs the wrong direction. And they took her into the principal's office, and the principal smacked her knuckles a couple of times for throwing snowballs the wrong direction.
Wow. Is that the right direction?
Well, apparently in this school, they wanted to keep you safe. So if you didn't want to get hit by the snowballs, you'd stay out of the way.
So you could only throw them like north and south, and she threw it east and west.
Whatever.
But it's really neat to be able to hear her tell that story.
Can you find that in there?
They can't, but they can't hear it.
Yeah, they can't hear it, so.
I might be able to find it on my phone. Let me see if I can.
Yeah, you could find it on your phone.
Sounds
so anyway, remember, this is something you can use to record and take pictures. You know, you can record things. If you go to the personal profile, so here, on the person profile in your phone.
Let me see if this works.
So.
Go ahead.
Okay. But it, remember the sound comes out of the bottom.
Yeah, but it's not turned up.
Maybe 10 years old, I think. 9 or 10. And it was a real snowy day. And you could only throw the snowballs one direction. And I threw a snowball a different direction. And they picked me up and took me into the office. And she took a little ruler and smacked my both my hands.
Oh, wow.
Oh. And that's it.
Oh, great.
She's never recovered.
Obviously, she still remembers. I recorded it onto my phone.
Yeah.
I did transfer it from something else.
Yeah.
And so it's really easy to just do it right on your phone.
So when you go to a person profile and you go to memories on your phone, there's a little plus sign. You can hit the plus sign, and the plus sign will say, what type of memory do you want to add? You can upload a photo from your phone, you can take a picture, you can record an audio.
Now where's that at? What screen did you get that?
Memories.
Memories?
Yeah, mm-hmm. No. What? No, you go to the person's profile.
It's on the person's page.
Person's
it's
profile,
person.
And you go to the memories.
On the person.
On the person.
Okay, so remember in details here, you've got details, sources, collaborate, memories. So you go to the memories. On the phone, you'll see the memories. And you can add memories right on the phone, or there's a memories app. So. So there's actually three family search apps. There's family search memories, family tree, and there's get involved. But I'd get both family tree and memories. So.
There's a memories app?
There's a memories app.
What's it look like?
It looks like.
I'll show you. It's the same thing, only it's green.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And what it does is it interacts with your gallery. So if you look at the memories app, it goes right to the gallery.
I'm downloading it right now.
Cool.
Yeah.
But you download it separately.
You load it separately. So what happens when you add a memory from the person's profile, it doesn't tag it very well. It tags the whole picture. You got to go in and edit that tag. But the profile, adding the memory to the memories app, then you have to go in and tag the people and identify who's in it. So, all right. So family search. How many people are in the tree? A whole bunch. Now, when you... People get really upset because somebody changed something about your tree.
Oh, that's good.
Got to remember, family search, family tree is not your tree. You have members, family members in the tree, but they're all your ancestors, but they're shared. And sometimes people make changes that you say weren't right. So you can correct them, make sure when you put things out there, you document them, and attach sources documenting the information.
Yeah.
So, if you look here, sources on mine, I've got the 1950 census.
Oops.
How many were alive in 1950 in this room?
Yep.
Okay, so here's the 1950 census. Well, look at this, mm-hmm. This is something that, so, look at this, and then we're gonna call it quits. So it's kind of fun to see yourself. Okay, Glenn H. Tolman, Dad, my mom, my two sisters, then I am, Glenn, right there.
First son.
Yeah.
How cool.
Then Byron, my brother, and my sister is there, but she's a month away from being born. So she's there with my mom, but not documented. Why not? She wasn't born. So people say, well, how come I'm not on that census? Well, you weren't alive. Censuses are snapshots of who was there at that house. So Lynn's father is on the 1940 census two times. He's on the 1930 census two times. Because they didn't do it at the same day, so they were two different places. So anyway, Family Search Family Tree.
That's cool.
It's collaborative, there's lots of things to do. And the work, is it ever done?
No, never.
No, it's never done. It's lots of fun, you can really enjoy. There's all kinds of things that you can do. Document things. Everybody has some photos stored in documents that you can add. Well, that's what we got for you, and hopefully this will motivate you to do even more. Yes?
23 years ago, we went on a mission to Nebraska.
Uh-huh.
And part of our mission was family history.
Yeah.
And we traveled to, what was it, 25 miles once a week.
Uh-huh.
To man this family history center in Kearney. We had a man come in with a whole bunch of stuff, and he wanted us to look it up on the computer. We found out he wasn't even a member.
Yeah.
It was kind of fun to do that.
Yeah.
And then when we come home, they had just moved into a new stake center in our area, and we were assigned to open the new family history center.
Uh-huh.
And we traveled to Salt Lake and ordered a whole bunch of computers to man that center.
Yeah.
And let me tell you, this is a whole different ball game.
And what it amounts to?
It's wonderful, but it's nothing compared to what we have.
It's amazing. And what happens? Is it the same? Is it going to be the same next year when you look at Family Tree? There'll be it's continually changing and evolving.
Yeah, that's amazing.
Yeah. All right.
When are you at the...
We're there on Wednesday nights from 5 to 9,
cool.
Every Wednesday. The family, there at the church, it's open 5, no, it's 10, 10 to 9.
10 to 9, 7 days a week.
Every day, 7 days a week.
Wow.
It's very nice. All right, Michael.
Thank you, guys.